Yes, we do. And I don't have that quantified right now, but we've come to learn that this virus affects many different systems in the body. We know that one of the receptors that it binds to is what we call an ACE2, angiotensin converting enzyme 2 receptor. And we know those receptors are in on our heart muscle, in our blood vessels, in our lungs, in the back of our throat, and that's how the virus can get into the body. But we know that those also have an effect on different organ and organ systems. And so, yes, what we are seeing are that there are things like clotting effects that people can have for a period of time. We know that there is some cognitive effects, that there have been people who've had small strokes related to infection with the virus. There is often a confusion that we don't know of exactly because it's from infection or whether it is exacerbation of the immune system causing cognitive dysfunction over time. So there has been reports of that as well. So these are all things that we have seen. I mean, very basically, the virus infects the lungs as well in many people, and you can have ongoing scarring and challenges with difficulty breathing. And really, what we hear the most is profound fatigue that takes a long time to get over. We have a number of processes in place. There are a couple of clinics to follow up people who've been tested positive and had illness, particularly people who have been hospitalized, because they are people who tend to have more prolonged illness. We also have a number of research projects that are looking at following up of people in both here in BC and as part of both national and international follow-up projects. So I don't have the details of those now, but I know that there's the clinicians are looking at how we can pull together the results that we've had here. Thankfully, a relatively low number of people here, but putting it together with colleagues across the country. The other one that is incredibly important that we've established early on was following people in pregnancy who become positive for COVID and following both mums and the babies that are born. And Dr. Deb Money has been leading that across the country, and we've been participating in that as well. So yes, these will come as the evidence accumulates over time, and I know that some of these will be published soon.